Thank you for the lessons. The mental ones, the ones that flit like thoughts, or they are thoughts. And when they happen, I can look at them and see that that is a reminder to practice putting my heart-fueled thoughts into my mind, into action, if you will, giving those intention, giving those power whenever something crosses my mind that's in the category of what I used to worry about, what called me into the rest of this, the reason I got scared into more beautiful things. I can use those thoughts now as reminders to put the power of my thought into where my will belongs. So, if that was too nebulous, if you have a thought that flits across your mind that is worry or fear or just weird, now think of it as a test. Like it's testing the firewall, and you remember, oh yes, this is a very small way of reminding me, a very gentle way, I shouldn't say small. Mind is not a small place, and it does not feel small in our bodies, but it is a gentle way of reminding us what thoughts we do want to have. So if that's the opposite thought that goes across our mind, let it go. Remember that that's a test, and put your true intention your heart power behind what you do want, and think of those flitting thoughts again, like testing the firewall, but to expand that a little bit is, if you were to think of your living this life as a walking meditation, those, you know, there's distractions that happen all the time where this is where we are. if you're around kids, or they don't necessarily need to be kids, they can just be other people who are distracting. You know what it's like to come back to yourself. Come back to yourself. That's the practice. That's what we practice. That's the meditation, or that's a part of some meditative practices, I should say. I would like to say meditation can be a lot of different things since I use that word pretty broadly. But that's the practice, and those are gentle lessons when it's just a thought that helps us to practice, rather than the actual experience playing out. Thank you. Thank you for giving these gentle lessons, these gentle reminders. Yes, we can be grateful for the things that we no longer want, because they happen and they remind us, they help us grow. There is no actual end to the challenges. There are times of rest from them, but it's not as though you're just done. You can take challenges with a grateful heart, saying thank you that the lesson wasn't harsher, that the challenge before you was helping you see in gentle ways. Going through my daily writing, my morning pages, I was reminded of a huge chunk of time my energy was just pouring into this negative thing that was happening with our house, and it wasn't even that negative, it just was not going the way that I wanted it to go. There were people involved that I did not want to speak to at all any longer because they lied, and I really do not take kindly to that. Anyhow. It's been about 8 months now, and I'm thankful it feels so long ago, and reminded that all the things that were coming to me, the clarifications, the messages, the good things happening inside of me, through me, were just blanketed over by this situation, and I got to a point of stress in which I was having heart palpitations, and looking back at things like that, maybe you can take your own examples, but if not, take mine and don't do it. Just remember that when you're going through something, think about who you are going to be 6 months from now, 1 year from now, 5 years from now. Is it going to matter? That advice is actually given to me by my sister, and I remember it, and it helps me. So I hope it helps you. If there's something going on right now, it could be a little thing that happens in the day. Is it going to matter 5 years from now? You know, that helps put it in its place. That gives it perspective. I will practice that because I'll remember that one. Because it came from somebody I listened to. And even though I may not practice all the time, all the things that come out of my mouth, I do try. But part of saying them is to speak to, is to be that person who's speaking, who I will listen to. And that is something I have to practice with myself. Perhaps you're the same way. Listening to yourself. We practice that. We practice listening to that gentle voice that isn't even really a voice sometimes. It's just a tiny little, it's a breath of air. It's a something that could be so easily dismissed, but as we listen to it, it gets stronger, more frequent. And that's how you build intuition. Or build your intuitive practice, perhaps, is a better way of saying that. And we can glean lessons from everywhere that we look. Everything can be a clue, a guidance, a remembering. If you happen to be a parent or a caretaker of a child going through phases of development, you may know how it is to have to give harsher lessons and tell them, you know, this is how the world works. If you don't listen to the nice way, then there are consequences. Please excuse my voice. I'm still recovering from COVID. It finally got me. If you are a caretaker, be careful. Right now, there are some parents with loosey-goosey practices about their sick kids, which is, you know, we're at the point where hopefully things are digestible now with this whole situation in the world. I say that knowing that I'm in a very lucky position, in a place where I can be vaccinated and can be safe most of the time. Or try to be. The consequences for a child are, again, a different kind of lesson. They may not be as gentle as saying things nicely, asking them nicely, explaining something nicely, but my point is, how does that relate to your relationship with your guidance, your inner guidance, whatever? Or maybe it feels external to you. That guidance. And that was a reminder that even when we have a spam call, it's an opportunity to come right back to what we were doing. before. I started posting my writing on a website, and I'm not to the point yet where it's writing that I want to record on here. I am getting to that portion of it. But that practice of putting stuff out there is kind of odd. It's a mixture of confidence where actually probably nobody's seeing it yet because they don't know how to find me. So I'm okay. It's like that's how I reduce the fear of putting stuff out there. I shouldn't say fear. What is it? Insecurity? I'm not even sure it's that. It's like just putting stuff out there for the first time. Maybe I didn't do enough of that before, and so I feel like a 10-year-old being exposed to their friends about something. I don't know. And it's also interesting to see how I want to change some of the ways that I say things for other people, because the way I write to myself is different. It's slightly different. I want to keep it pretty much the same. But that one tiny bit is a reminder of, or can be a reminder, to look at how we speak to ourselves. Is it different than how we would speak about ourselves to other people, or speak to other people about themselves? Just becoming aware of how you operate in the world and what things can be gleaned, what understandings can be gleaned about how about the guidance that you receive, or the messages that you receive. Remember that when other people are saying things to you, they might be saying them in ways that they deeply understand, and you are meant to catch the gems that you are meant to keep and weave into your own understanding. Don't get too sucked into what somebody else understands for themselves, although that is good. It's just difficult to be somebody else. It's we all have our own inner spaces, and this is what we all can be practicing, is developing that inner space for ourselves, reaching within. So with that in mind, be as you are. Be as you are, and whew, and be breathed by spirit. Thank you. Be as you are and be charged by spirit. Be as you are and be nourished, supported, guided, always by this force living through you experiencing through you. And I use the word you here to explain the fleshy device that we are, that lets us be tactile in this world, our bodies. But I mean the deeper you as well, of course. You get it. Be as you are. Be as you are in all of those layers. And make your own wishes for the world. Serenity, prosperity, health, wealth, connections, freedom, collaboration, community, reimagining. Exploring the diversity of all the ways there are to be, all the beautiful ways there are to be. We know some of the other ways, and we know that even a tiny prickle of those ways is enough of a reminder to not go down that path. Where else can we go? Where else have we not reached into and breathed into in our living practice that is more beautiful, more interesting, more intriguing and rejuvenating? Let's go there. And even as many days as we put wishes into the world, every day matters, and every day, like layers on top of one another, it just powers up. It's like jet stream of energy into this space. Like to have those wishes true. They can feel so potent in your heart, and you put that out and you have it inside, and then you just smile at yourself, because if you were the Emperor Empress of the universe, it would all be so. And so it is.
If I had been made invisible.